So welcome back on Watch Advice on YouTube. Today I am with Sylvain Dolan.
Hello, Alexander.
He's in the captain's chair wearing a captain's jacket. Of course, I'm on the co-pilot's chair. Don't forget to subscribe and to hit the bell to get our latest notifications. We are in Biel at the headquarters. Sylvain is the CEO of Hamilton.
Yes.
And Biel is located in the heart of Switzerland. It's where the both parts of Switzerland, the German-speaking and the French part, meet. And so we are in kind of a gray zone. And that's why we are speaking English, not French, not German. Anyhow, nobody would have understand. No, not enough people. Sylvain, talking about the history of Hamilton. Hamilton was a brand that was very early, in very, very early days, also delivering watches to the military.
Yes, and in particular the pilots.
To the pilots.
Yes, that's why today I'm not a pilot. I wear a pilot jacket because we're going to present you some pilot watches from our rich history. But actually last year we celebrated the 100 years of Hamilton timing the sky, because we first delivered in the United States already now 101 years ago watches to pilots. And back in the end of the 60s and beginning of the 70s, we have been working extensively with the Royal Air Force.
The British Royal Air Force.
To provide the Royal Air Force some beautiful watches that were following the strict guideline of the British Royal Air Force. And this is what we are reinterpreting this year. So here on this table you have a beautiful chronograph that you can see, which was integrating a Valjoux 7733 in those days. Hamilton has been a pioneer in launching the first chronograph, one of the first chronograph caliber 11. And then later on, we worked with the Valjoux references. Still today, last year, we launched the first Valjoux movement with silicone air spring.
Yeah, you have to know that Valjoux, meanwhile, is a company belonging to Swatch Group. It's part of ETA.
Exactly.
But you know, there is, you know, all of course, those famous Valjoux 7750 that have been, I would say, saving the industry after the quartz crisis, because without that famous chronograph movement, I think most of the companies wouldn't have been able to present any watches on the market.
Yeah. So. And actually all our chronograph use this base, this Valjoux base, which is really robust, solid, and considered an extremely reliable movement.
Yeah. But we're not talking about the chronograph, but the chronograph will be a project maybe next year or later. We will see.
Every time I see you, I come back after to the creative team and say, hey, we have discussed that, can you look into it?
No, but...
But I would love to redo it.
Before really going into the piece that will come on the markets, I show you this lovely chronograph again. But that's a historical piece out of the Museum of Hamilton. It's not the piece they have been just manufacturing, even it looks like. On that beautiful leather NATO strap, that would be a watch in the stores today that would sell like hell. Sorry. You got the point?
I love it. I love it too.
You love it too. Okay, but before talking about the chronograph, let's really jump into a watch I very much like, because it is, on the one hand side, taking history. It is what people are looking for. It's historical pieces, redone, re-editions. And it's small, because we have so many complaints. When finally can we get a watch that is below 40 millimeters? Yeah. Hey, voila, there it is.
So, ready for Christmas.
Sylvain, tell me about the new Hamilton.
So actually the story of this watch goes back to the beginning of the 70s, delivered to the Royal Air Force. And what I love in this watch is a very particular shape of the lugs. You can see it's asymmetric. It's not round, it's asymmetric shape. And the glass that is coming clearly outside, so giving a very good readability to the number. And we decided, actually, when we were preparing the 100 years of Timing the Sky, we were reviewing we were presenting the new models we were launching, and we took out this piece and we say, wow, it's beautiful. We cannot let that only in the archives. We have to rework it, and we have reworked it, but staying really close to the original design. You can still see exactly the same similarity in the shape of the lugs, but
Not looking on the dial, it's difficult to see a difference.
Yeah.
When you look at the dial,
we have played around, but we stayed as true as possible with the numeral 1-to-1, but we gave We have the chance to have in our group superb factories for dial, and we gave a little grain aspect to give a little bit of structure compared to the more plain dial of the original one. But that's the only little difference we have allowed ourselves, along with replacing the little arrow, which is a protected design from the Royal Air Force.
We have to we have to go in that little detail, because Now, people watching will say, okay, there is that famous arrow on the dial. Why don't we find the arrow again on the re-edition? So, as you might know, this little arrow is a part of the Air Force.
So it's the logo from the Royal Air Force.
So the Royal Air Force. And now, listen, this is protected not only by the Royal Air Force, but also by the Queen herself, or Her Majesty, we have to say. Her Majesty owns the rights of the arrow. So if you find the arrow on a watch, it's probably not supposed to be there, because
it depends. You can probably
negotiate.
You can have the right. But the reason why we wanted also to keep this space free is that we have integrated in this watch a movement that we are the only brand to use, which is a hand wound movement called H50 done for Hamilton with hand winding, which enable us to have a thinner watch, and we wanted to mention it on the dial, so there is not so much space, so we had to remove this symbol and replace it by mechanical. That's the only difference between the original and the reinterpretation that we launched now.
Very nice. And if you open the historical piece, of course, on the backside, you will find specifications of the military, including once again the arrow, and some military specification, yes. W10/6645/99, whatever this means, to really... The watch was used, do you know, by coincidence, how long the military used the watch?
I don't know. But the other day, I saw a very interesting picture from the prince, the British prince, wearing a khaki that he got from his military service. Wow. I'll show you the picture after.
It's okay, really great. Cool. Yeah, that's good. The watch will come. No, I have to take the correct. The watch will come on. Is on the market?
It's on the market now. It's on the market. Launched it a few weeks ago.
It's not a limited edition.
It's not a limited edition.
So it's good to go. It's 39 or 38?
38 and 36.
Okay. 38, 36. Lug to lug distance, I will add in the description of the video. So that very important lug to lug distance. Has a hand wound movement. Is not limited, and in the at Hamilton authorized dealers and boutiques. You also have boutiques.
Yes.
And it's sold for
795 Swiss francs.
795 Swiss francs. Any questions? No. No questions. And if you know, and that is also what you very often read in when I'm answering comments. I'm a big fan of Swatch Group, not only because I like their designs and their nice CEOs like Sylvain.
No. Thank you.
No. We are friends for so many years now. But if you go into a Swatch Group, you know what they do is they deliver quality. They deliver value for money. And it's not just delivering a watch for, let's say, a price, 795, but compare. Just go to be safe on the safe side. Take one of those watches from Swatch Group or Hamilton or whatever brand of Swatch Group and compare it for the same money for any other brand. And I promise you, you will be disappointed. Not for Swatch Group, but for the other brand. It's not because I'm here. It's not because I'm at Swatch Group today. I have to say this. There's no one standing behind me with a gun telling. I'm saying this because it's true. And I'm really... a fan of what they do in sense of what they have on the upper scale product range, like Blancpain and all the other brands, Breguet and so on. But if you go down, it's much more difficult, and you know that.
Yeah, it's
to keep prices and to keep quality.
It's an obsession.
It's a nightmare.
By working on the details of the design and not making any compromise. But it's fun because it's a big challenge to bring very high perceived value. Movement wise, we have the chance to be part of the group, and ETA is extremely reliable partner. But not only, for example, the dial here was a fun project to develop with our factory in La Chaux-de-Fonds, and we have the chance to have passionate people in the factories that help us to meet the quality we want and remaining at the price we want. The only challenge we have is volume, 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 and that's why you won't see hundreds of new reference for Hamilton every year, but rather 50, 60 new references, because we have to focus on the volume to be able to make the price we want to reach in the market.
Yeah, but end of the day, someone buying the watch gets a beautiful designed watch, beautiful looking watch, and it also in terms of technology and reliability, a perfect watch. Mm. And this is what you want. Huh? You don't want to get screwed when you buy.
Value for money, you said.
Yeah,
it's something which is important, which has always been part of the the culture of the
brand. And I really recommend you look twice before buying and always consider to have a Swatch Group brand beside when you buy from any other brands that are in comparable segments. And you will probably be convinced, as I am, that there's a little difference in price and quality. And that difference is, makes that decision. Nice watch.
Thank you, Alexander.
Very nice. Sylvain.
Khaki Pioneer.
Khaki and the captain here. Okay, we are landing now. We are going to land again in Biel after our... And I have to go back to this one. When I saw it now, when I came, I thought this is a new reference and he's already pulling something out of 2020, but it is a watch from a museum
I know you like beautiful historical watches. Yeah, that's why we put them out.
The quality, it looks like new.
Yes, but we have 2,000 watches in our historical collection that we really pamper because they are a source of inspiration. We should not only focus on this. We have to be modern, contemporary.
Yeah, of course.
But we have to have, we have not to forget the rich history of the brand because it's unique. There are not many brands in the watch industry that has such a rich history in terms of movement manufacturing, in terms of innovation, first quartz, first digital watch, first electric watch with Aventura, first chronograph, among the first chronograph automatic. So for us, every day when we think about our history, we put the bar a little higher in what we have to do for the next years because our predecessors have done an amazing job.
So we can also expect this wonderful chronograph to be part of the collection in the future.
Let's see.
Because Sylvain, if he's not doing it, you all going to write emails, shoot me some emails and I forward them to Sylvain to make this watch as part of the collection in the next days. Now, okay, now we are landing. Bye from me.
Thank you very much.
Sylvain, thank you very much for sharing the passion with me.
Thank you. Thanks for your passion.
Yes, and I'm sure these watches will really sell.
Thank you.